Welcome to this part 4 session on data encryption standard, the DES. In this session, we will decrypt the ciphertext that we built in part 3 and build plain text using the same 16 subkeys that we have derived in part 2. We assume that you have already viewed our earlier 3 parts, else you'll feel discontinuity in following this tutorial. Please download the Excel workbooks from the address given below. There are no macros in that Excel workbooks. We have used regular formulae and functions only. The decryption process is not any different from what we did during encryption. Even here, we begin with IP permutation of the input text, then split it into two halves, and all the remaining steps are same as what we did for encryption. Simply because this is decryption, we are not going to reverse the steps like moving from round 16 to round 1. The points of differences are we will use ciphertext instead of plain text, and the subkeys will be fed in the reverse order from key 16 onwards to key 1 instead of key 1 to key 16. When we reach the final R0 L0, we'll do an IP inversion like we did during encryption. If you are comfortable with our encryption sheet, the decryption is nothing but a copy of the entire process. Let us now go into decryption process. Before entering Feistel round 1, we have the IP permuted L16 and R16. We begin with L16 but leave it as it is until we consider it for XR in step 7. Next, a copy of R16 is stored in L15. This is one of the outputs of this round 1. We use the same 32-bit R16 and permute it with EBIT table. The output now is 48 bits long. XR this 48-bit output with the subkey K16. We use key K16 because this is round 1 of the decryption mode, where we use the keys in the reverse order. The 48-bit output is split into 6 bits each, and its value is taken from the substitution tables. Substitution part has already been explained in part 3 of our DES algorithm video. The output of the substitution table is permuted using P-bit table. XR the output of P-bit permutation with L16 that we have kept aside in step 1. This output is our new R15. Notice we have already obtained L15 in step 2. This completes the mixer block of the Feistel network. We now store this R15 in L14 for use in next round. This is swapper block. Within one decryption round of Feistel network, this is what happens. We are now ready to move on to round 2. Let us check this implementation of the above steps in our Excel sheet. We'll be using the regular IP, EBIT, PBIT, IP inversion and set of 8 substitution tables here too, like we did in encryption round. No change here. The ciphertext in row 6 is copied from the summary sheet AK2 to AZ2. It is converted into binary and placed in row 7. The binary ciphertext in row 7 is permuted using the IP table available in row 2 and written in row 8. The permuted ciphertext in row 8 is split into two halves. The left part L16 is placed in row 9. And the right part R16 in row 10. This is where we enter the decryption round 1 of the Feistel network. The input to this round are L16, R16 and subkey K16. We leave L16 untouched until step 7, as we did in encryption round 2. A copy of R16 is now stored in L15 in row 11. Row 10 is permuted with EBIT selection table in row 3 and written in row 12. Notice row 10 was 32 bit, but row 12 is 48 bits. Copy subkey K16 from the keys sheet into row 13. Remember, we use K16 because we are in round 1 of encryption. XR row 12 and row 13 and write it in row 14. We now use values in the row 14 and the substitution tables to get new values and write them in row 15. Substitution operation has already been explained in part 3. Like in encryption, here too, row 16 is redundant since we copy values from row 15 and put them all together serially. Otherwise, row 15 and 16 are same. Permute this row 16 using PBIT tables and write in row 17. XR row 17 with row 9, which contains L16. This row 18 gives us R15. We started with R16 and now we get our R15 here. This completes the mixer block of Feistel network. From row 11 we get L15 and row 18 gives us R15. These two are the output of decryption round 1. Before we move on to round 2, we store this R15 in L14 in row 19. This operation is called swapping. Have you noticed the decryption text available at the end of round 1 in AH11 to AW11 is the same as the one we had at the beginning of 16th encryption round, AH130 to AW130 of the encryption sheet? You may check this for the remaining rounds also. This means the encryption and decryption text match round for round. We have placed these keys in the summary sheet C10 to AH26, and you may check for yourself if the round wise keys matching pattern. The above sets of operation are repeated 16 times, 2, 3, 4 and so on until we get L0 and R0 in rows 131 and 138. These L0 and R0 are arranged as R0, L0 in row 139. Now we apply IP inversion permutation given in row 5. Row 140 is our plain text in binary format and row 141 is the binary converted into hexadecimal. This row 141 plain text is carried to summary sheet AK3 to AZ3.
This completes the decryption process.
If you wish to try decrypting your own ciphertext, here is what you do. Enter the appropriate key in C2R2 and the ciphertext in C4R4 of the summary sheet. The plain text does not matter here. And set cell Z2 to 1. If it had been correctly encrypted, then you will get your plain text in AK3 to AZ3 on the same sheet. If the cell Z2 contains 0, the system considers the ciphertext from B141 to P141 are the encryption sheet. Let's see a simple demo. When Z2 contains 0, you will see the ASCII text displays welcome with exclamation in AK4 to AR4, which is based on the ciphertext from the encryption sheet. Note the exclamation at the end. The current content of C4 to R4 is for ASCII welcome double quotes. Note the double quote at the end of the ASCII text. Now set Z2 to 1, you will get the new ASCII with the double quotes. Try it out yourself. In part 3, we told you that Pi-STEL networks are very appealing, not just due to their simple design, but also because the same hardware circuit can be used for both encryption and decryption. But how? Look at the Pi-STEL network design. In an abstract approach, as a circuit, it expects 2 32 bits, the message parts, and 1 48 bit, the keys part, as input, and gives 2 32 bits as output. Call them whatever. You might even extend the 16 rounds of encryption to 32 or any number. It was decided 16 rounds are sufficient for strong encryption, and so we stop there. We don't even have to show 16 arrays inside the box. Only one would have been sufficient, and we need to program the circuit to iteratively encrypt and give us the output. On the first round, we call it ciphertext, and the next round, we call it plain text. The keys also don't have to be 16. Simply supply the main key, the system could identify and lift shift the bits the appropriate number of times and use the output as the relevant subkey. What we call as encryption or decryption doesn't really matter to the circuit. It just receives the input, runs the logic, and gives the output. The real genius is in the logical design of the number patterns that has gone into the encryption and decryption that really deserves mention. We suggest that you work with various texts and keys and get a handle on this encryption and decryption using our DES algorithm.